This is Richard, and the Harvest Hour today is visiting with Brenda Webb, Mary Hill, and Patricia Messer, and we're going to talk about the Eureka Springs Garden Club Spring Garden Tour, and this year the theme is Off the Beaten Path. Mary, I want to go on a tour this year. How do I go about that?
You can buy a ticket from any garden club member or from the Chamber of Commerce or from the Historical Museum. They are $15 each or $10 for groups of 10 people or more. And it's all on the Red Line, so you can get on and off the trolley. And it's 9 B&Bs. And these are gardens that you don't normally get to see unless you're a paying guest of the B&B. And we have two churches which have been on the tour before, St. Elizabeth's Catholic Church and St. James Episcopal Church, as well as the Carnegie Library, where the Garden Club has an ongoing renovation project of the grounds. So although you may have seen one or two of these before, there are always new things going on in gardens, and one of the things that we have going this year is an art project with Chris Fisher and John Rankin, who are the owner of the Space Art Gallery, and they're sponsoring exhibitions of artists' works with natural products, materials called, and this will be called Finding Nature Artworks in the Landscape. So you're going to be sort of on a little treasure hunt because we don't know where they're putting all of these sculptures. And that will make it a little more interesting to walk through the gardens. At St. James Church at noon, we have Arthur and herbalist Stephen Foster, and he will be talking about some of the herbs in the Ozarks. And after his talk, you can refresh yourself with some cookies and cool beverages in the church undercroft, is what we call it, but it's what, you know, the parish hall area. So
sounds like a great time. What time of day does the tours begin, and when do they end?
It starts at 10 o'clock in the morning and it ends at 3 p.m.
And so we can participate any time during that,
yes,
that time period.
Great. Any time during the morning, during that day.
And so tell me again now, where would I get a ticket, and or who would I call to contact?
You can call me at 253-7078 or the Chamber of Commerce at, I don't know the number. The Chamber of Commerce or the Historical Museum, they have tickets available. If you want to use a credit card, I would go to the Chamber of Commerce because they accept credit cards. The rest of us have to have cash or a check. The tickets are $15 each or $10 for groups of 10 or more.
And those are good all day, so we could take all day to do this if we want.
You can take as long as you like.
We can go shopping in between.
Encourage you to go shopping in between. The shop owners downtown would enjoy having you come in their shop.
Well, again, we're talking with Brenda and Mary and Patricia of the Eureka Springs Garden Club, and we're going to take a break now, but we'll be right back in just a minute.
I'm Salmonella, national spokesman for the synthetically produced vegetable matter, Spavin. These are tough times for scientists and marketing executives in chemical agriculture. Unfair competition cropping up from everywhere with these dirt farmers. Farmers' markets are sprouting up everywhere. More than 5,000 in the U.S. already. They waste your time going on and on about how they grow your food, what they put on it. It's unfair. I can't do that. How do you work chlorine dioxide, phytic acid, or propiconazole into a sentence with a lady holding a pair of drooling toddlers? It's unfair! These local dirt farmers actually grow their food in animal poo for fertilizer instead of using petroleum products, taking away the livelihood of poor and struggling oil companies. Have they no hearts? Remember the scientists. Remember the chemical makers. And please, remember the poor, struggling oil men here in America and over there in the struggling Middle East. And choose Spavin, your synthetically produced vegetable matter.
Hi, Well, we're back and still talking about the spring garden tour off the beaten path. And ladies, tell me more about the garden club. When did you get this started, and why are you doing this tour? What's going on?
Okay. The garden club was organized in March of 1946. So it has a long history.
Wow.
This is the 66th year. And we feel very blessed to have a beautiful place like Eureka Springs in which to live, and want all of us feel strongly about keeping, preserving the gardens of Eureka Springs and encouraging others to do likewise. So that is one of the reasons for having this tour, is to show some of the gardens that most people will not even see unless they're on the tour. And we have guest speakers, of course, that will elaborate on what we're doing. And it's very interesting. I think it'll be very interesting to everyone.
I think that's great. And it fits right in with what the Harvest Hour likes to report on, and what Carroll County Fresh's mission statement is, preserving and encouraging gardening and agriculture in the community. You have the theme this year of Off the Beaten Path. How did you come up with that name, and how did you choose the gardens that we're going to be looking at this year?
Well, we have another member that's not present today, Laurie Kilgore, and she helped plan the garden tour and visited a lot of the gardens, as well as Mary Hill, and selected them. We always have a committee that selects the gardens, and they decided to do bed and breakfast this year. And this will be in an area that's, I've had a lot of people ask me if they could possibly ride the trolley the whole way, and they can, and get off the trolley and back on, which will help a lot for people with bad knees and that type of problem, which a lot of us have. And I said a lot of most of the tour, though, will be on level ground this year, so there might not be a problem.
If anybody wants to join the garden club, how do they go about that? Are you looking for members, or?
It used to be we had to vote on them, but we've opened the doors now, and anyone that wants to get their hands dirty and work in the yard, in the gardens, is welcome.
Well, that sounds great.
We have 19 members at present, and we have room for 25. So if anyone's interested in gardening, they can contact me or any member of the garden club.
And how would they contact you?
By phone.
And that number would be?
981-6076.
So that's 981-6076 if you care to become a member of the Eureka Springs Garden Club. And I want to buy tickets for this, and let's go over those phone numbers again.
Okay, you can buy a ticket from the Eureka Springs Chamber of Commerce at 479-253-8737, and or the Eureka Springs Historical Museum at 253-9417, or from me at 253-7078. And these are $15 for one person, or $10 each for groups of 10 or more.
And you'll also be selling these tickets the day of the event?
Yes, that's right, at the trolley office at Plainer Hill parking lot, which is at the intersection of Plainer Hill and Highway 62 across from the community bank.
And that would be Saturday, May 19th, 2012, at
yes.
10 o'clock?
10 to 3.
You could get there a little early and get your ticket, and make sure you got on that 10 o'clock
yes.
trolley to get on the tour early.
And be finished in time to hear Stephen Foster at St. James Episcopal Church at noon.
All right. Who is Stephen Foster, and why do you have him speaking on the garden tour?
He's fantastic. He is the author of 17 books, and actually started gardening at the age of 19 in Maine, in the state of Maine, and has been with it all this time. Has tremendous knowledge of every plant.
He's an herbalist too, and a great photographer, and he worked for, I believe, National Geographic, and has done a lot of field guides, and what else has he done? A desk reference to Nature's Medicine, and so he's a fun person to listen to. He really is.
Well, that's great. So again, Eureka Springs Garden Tour off the beaten path, and you can call 253-7078 or 253-8737 or 253-9417 and get your tickets, and they are $15 a piece, or if 10 people or more, it is
$10
a piece. And you can also, of course, the morning of Saturday, May 19th, at Plainer Hill Trolley Station, you can buy your tickets there.
And I won't.
So, where is this money going that I'm going to give you for my ticket?
It will go into buying plants and soil for the gardens of Eureka Springs. And we are dedicating this tour to Don E. Allen, who's a landscape designer of Eureka Springs Public Gardens. We're doing this in an appreciation for designs which inspire us all to create beauty whenever we can.
And I certainly understand honoring that after touring Eureka Springs and living here and always seeing the beautiful gardens that are always present in the public facilities around town. Well, I have to say, ladies, it's been really fun to talk to you, and I can't wait to go on the tour. And the tour again is Saturday, May 19th, 10 o'clock. So I'll be meeting all of you up on Plainer Hill on Saturday morning, the 19th. So see you then. And this is Richard for the Ozark Harvest Hour, and I'll be seeing you again on the radio.
Hello again from the Carroll County Literacy Council. We've been busy this spring with a fundraising drive and some new student recruitment, as well as starting a new project called The Little Guides, funded by a grant from the Youth Advisory Council of the Carroll County Community Foundation. The Little Guides is a program to help young people who are the only English-speaking person in their family, providing books, reading, and discussion and communication issues with parents and grandparents. Lots of exciting things happening to us this year. Please consider supporting us by passing along referrals of potential clients and students, becoming a friend of the Literacy Council, or even more helpful, joining with the First Christian Church, Carroll County Fresh, the Ozark Harvest Radio Hour, First National Bank of North Arkansas, and It's a Mystery Bookstore as a sustaining sponsor. A special thank you to our newest sustaining sponsor, The Storage Solution, located on Highway 23, 3 miles north of the Holiday Island main entrance. Owners are Jane and Richard Pille. You can reach us at our phone number, 870-505-1556, or visit us at our website, www.carrollcountyliteracy.org, where we have a donation page with all pertinent information. And mainly, just keep us in mind, we are the Literacy Council, and we would love to help.